Hello, beautiful souls. Welcome back to the Tarot Closet. Welcome. If you're new to the channel, thank you so very much for joining me. I really appreciate you taking time out of your day, out of your life. So today's reading is messages from your person. This is all signs for the collective. Take what resonates for you, of course, and let the rest go. What does that mean, messages from your person? For the most part, that's most likely a no contact and or in separation reading, however that resonates for you. But if you find yourself here, there's a reason. So it can be that the message, the entire reading feels like a private reading, but it can also be that there's just particular messages, you know, or one message for you. Now, before we get into your reading, I would like to invite you to like today's reading and subscribe to the Tarot Closet. If you have not, this really helps so much more than you know to continue growing the channel so that I can continue bringing you more readings. So thank you very much in advance. That kind of just was flipping off. Okay, well, it's already the Lover's card, so we're going to keep that. And so this is how the reading is going today. Down below, you will find all the links in the description. Lots of stuff going on down there, so if you feel inspired to check it out, the tarotcloset.com is there. I do offer personal readings. However, at the moment, my online readings are closed. I am booked full, so I am not accepting new readings at the moment. But if you're interested and you want to sign up for the waitlist, you can just follow the link below. You can even just go straight to the book a reading link, and it will just give you a space to sign up with your email for the waitlist. So also down, I will link all the cards that come in, and I'm kind of ahead of myself. There's a lot of fiery energy here. I'm sort of jumping ahead. Anyway, I will link all the decks, and you will also find all the playlists, of course, messages from your person. Also, very long, in-depth twin flame readings. If you are on a twin flame journey, maybe you're just curious. Readings, some kind of new readings that I've begun. It's Love Tarot for Soulmates and Twin Flames. So it's sort of like maybe one or both comes through for you, but the messages are for someone. So there are some also down below there. In any case, feel free to browse. Messages are all timeless. All readings are timeless, and they're meant for you when you get to them. And, you know, it can be, again, that a reading feels like it's yours, or there's just particular messages. These are general readings, so remember to take what's for you and let the rest go. Energies, outcomes, they will, and they do change. Everyone has free will. The future is not fixed. Whoa. Okay. You guys, there's three major arcanas here already. The Lover's card in the upright. So this is somebody that you love very much, that also loves you. It looks very highly likely that there is either a choice that has been made or really needs to be made, but somebody is having a hard time making it. Look, somebody's having a hard time coming with the truth. And I feel it's about how they feel about you. It can also be something that went on in this connection. It's the Justice card. This is Libra energy. It's also Venus, the planet of love. Justice wants to restore justice, truth, harmony, balance. Look, here she is. She's heading into some connection, and there's three here, as you can see. That's the two of you, and that's the divine here. Yeah, restoring justice when the timing is right. And look, she's just standing here. Is she going to walk through now? Is that later? It is divine timing, and it's sort of like up to the hands of, you know, how do you want to put that in? You can see they're both coming through. It's sort of this let go, let God feeling. But on the other hand, I'm also on, no pun intended, you guys. I'm also seeing kind of like reciprocity, you know, that's like giving and receiving and balance. And it wasn't. This can be about emotional energy of how somebody's feeling. It can also be something particularly happened. The High Priestess is here, and it's divine feminine energy. It's Cancer and energy, and it's a decision I feel like somebody's afraid to make. Guys, I want to show you the actual card. Look, there's the hand. It's real prominent. It's almost like the Hamza, but it's also here. Look, somebody who might be a little bit in their ego. What's going on? It's in reverse. So it's also somebody who's kind of blocked, clouded insight. They're not really seeing, you know, or they know it's there, but they don't want to face it. They don't want to, what's going on? You know, you can see it's kind of half of the face is covered here. And again, it's in reverse with the Justice card and the Lover's card. So there's a lot of love here, very clearly, but there's some kind of truth that needs to come out. Yeah. And the High Priestess, you know, is holding a lot of secrets. You know, there's a real mysterious energy and it's in reverse here. So somebody wants, I feel, to share something with you, the truth. What is the truth? Is it how they feel? Is it about something that happened? Maybe something you still need to know, because there's a lot of mysterious energy here, but it's somebody who's holding back from it. Thank you, spirit guides, angels and ancestors. How many are here? It's way too many, okay? Can you please show us what is going on? And this message is from, look, there's Justice again. It's not really clear. Is this the upright? It might even be that it's in reverse here, and that is the truth coming. Interesting. And it's also the Hierophant coming through. This is another major arcana, my gosh, you guys. And Taurus energy, also Jupiter energy. Yeah, and Jupiter energy is, well, the planet of expansion. You know, it's getting some information, you know, the wisdom, just the knowledge, and being able to take that information and move forward and grow and have, yeah, a prosperous, abundant outcome. Look, it's interesting because you see that quite literally here in the Hierophant. Look at the apples here. Are these apples? Are these peppers? Oh my gosh. You know, look, it's, no, they're candles. They're candles that have been knocked over. Interesting. I never noticed that. And of course, it's the Hierophant. So this is a five, and that is about change. It's also connected to the throat chakra and the truth. Oh my gosh, you guys. And the Hierophant energy, it can be that there are some differences here in religion. Also some family energy coming through, location, religious, cultural differences. And the thing too is Hierophant for me is kind of a card of commitment in the sense that it's contracts, it's marriage contracts, it's slow moving partnerships. And we do see three people here. Somebody's close to this candle that's burning and somebody's far away and the candle almost looks like it's gonna drop. My gosh. And this Hierophant energy, you can see it's a divine feminine energy here, and it's not about gender. We know that. She has a cloak over her head. It's a lot like what we saw, what's that, in the High Priestess in reverse energy. So somebody here is having a hard time coming with the truth. What is it? Can it be that there's another connection involved? It can. Another contract can be marriage. It can also be a soul contract, which is not always going to mean long-term. Sometimes we have these contracts and people are going to come and go and they're not going to be long-term energy. Can it be this is a marriage contract with you? Let's see, guys. And remember, take it how it resonates. But so far, all we have seen are major arcana cards here. Thank you, spirit guides, angels, and ancestors. Let's get one more. Yeah, so still here in the reverse. This is somebody who's just not being honest. This is somebody who they're not, something went on here, or they're not being honest how they feel. Because look, it's the Eight of Emotions. And it's interesting because we saw it in the upright. So it's somebody who's trying, because this is in reverse. So this is somebody who wants to come back and has kind of learned their lesson, so to speak. Look, it's looking a lot like a lunar eclipse, doesn't it? And that's a harbinger of change. You know, it's emotional cycles running their course. It's like a culmination and just needing to let things go. Somebody here was moving out of the way, but it's a spinner because look, now they're coming back. Eight is a number of action. It's still an eight here in the reverse. It's also a infinity symbol. I try not to give you the bird, which can for some of you bring in twin flame energy, also with the Justice, also with the Lover's card. So that's real clear for a lot of you that this is your twin flame. It's also soulmate energy here, guys. But that's also life force and forever love and lack of balance. So is this person, did something go on in here? And because it's sort of like they went off and got some information. They may have gone into the hangman energy, you know, got a different perspective and gained some wisdom. They may have gone into the hermit energy. Okay, bringing in some Virgo energy here, Mercury going, you know, just went within to try to get some clarity and some spiritual illumination, excuse me, and that seeing the big picture and seeing how they're connected. It can be that there's some religious related, excuse me, coming in for some of you. That won't be for everyone because this is also a spiritual reading, you know, but we saw that in the Hierophant card. But this is somebody coming back who gathered some information and kind of wants to, what I feel like is apologize. Like I learned my lesson, but they're still having trouble getting it out here. Okay. What's going on with this energy? And this one was wanting to slide off. So, and it brought another with it, and it's also taking this, and this is coming. So this is how your reading's going today. Yeah, it's the Two of Voices and it's in reverse. So it's somebody who's indecisive and it's in the partnership placement. And we saw that. They're just kind of having a hard time. Look at all the emotions though. This is Pisces energy. This is the Ten of Cups. It can't even be that that the two of you were living together or had some kind of legal or just, we already know the soul connection, but there can't even be that there was a marriage, and it can be that there is with someone else. But what came through for me as it was coming down is it's also something that got interrupted, you know, whether it was already happening and it was interrupted, or it was in motion, or it's simply this dreamy energy. But this is somebody who's confused about it and indecisive and might be overwhelmed by something too. And we saw that in the High Priestess in reverse, that they're kind of blocked from making a decision. It's in the partnership placement. So it can be somebody that you've been waiting on. Look, and the Justice is coming back in the upright. Okay, that's actually a good sign. And maybe it's the truth just coming out in the reading. Maybe it's going to actually come in another way. It can be that when they get unstuck here, that it's a voice message or it's a conversation, because this is somebody heading for being unstuck. And then look, it's the divine again up here. You're connected. Look, your hair is sort of connected and these arms are holding on to both of you. Look, I mean, it's like such a wild card, isn't it? And then it's in reverse. So we know that they're indecisive here. And yeah, so this can be that a voice, they upright this, because this is kind of day-to-day energy, you know, for me. And so it can be somebody who's hot or cold or is just struggling with things. And maybe we'll see a lot of wand energy, because I do feel that fiery, fast energy that they'll come out of nowhere. But this is where their energy is the strongest. It's what I call the naughty corner if you're new to my readings. Yeah, oh, look. Gosh, you guys. Interesting. And I won't go into why, but it's just kind of in humor. But it's where their energy is the strongest, and it's the Justice card, you know, new beginnings. For some of you, this might be a twin flame connection. Again, it's super strong that it's here. It's not for everybody. But this is also that too, bringing you both in, the lack of balance, the duality. So this person wants to say something, and I feel like there's a really strong connection that you have. Look. This is a very hopeful, it's one of many beautiful cards. It's all the love here, it's a new cycle, it's all the emotions. But I also feel like this is how they feel, and it looks a little bit of like a dreamy state. Do you know what I mean? With this mandala here, it's, yeah, I mean, and it is Pisces energy. It's like head in the clouds feeling. And that's not surprising. Yeah, look, it's the Queen of Pentacles showing itself, but it might even have been in reverse because I was moving the deck around. Let's see what's coming through. But the Six of Emotions, guys, and this is what I felt, and this is kind of here too. It can also be somebody who's nostalgic for what didn't happen or what got interrupted. And it's kind of both of your energy, okay? Or what could maybe still be. It's the Six of Emotions. That's the Six of Cups. This is the Sun in Scorpio. And this is the nostalgic energy, thinking about, will I see my person again? Will we even talk again? This is somebody thinking about reunion energy. It's really strongly here. Look, sitting on, it's a child sitting on a suitcase. And this can bring in that you've known this person since childhood. can also be that you just feel like you've known this person forever. Yes, this brings in past life and or twin flame energy for some of you. That won't be for everybody. But this is a journey. It's a physical journey, possibly packing up the suitcase, packing up. There's also a lot. What's in that suitcase? Because, you know, children often fill their suitcase with things that aren't useful, you know, but a lot of toys and a lot of other things. So it can be that it's just a whole lot of dreamy energy and they're not able to realize that. And it can be physical movement, but also the journey of love. And that's obvious. And it almost looks like, is that Saturn? Is that the moon? Look, it almost looks like they're balancing, reaching out, and there's Saturn here above them. I don't know if you see that. Is that, would that be Jupiter? I don't know if you can see that. It's kind of strange. And Saturn is the slowest moving energy, you know. It can sometimes cause some misery, you know, and problems. But in any case, there's three people here. So it's also the divine timing. And of course, there's a lot of emotions. We already know that. A lot of nostalgic energy. And they can be coming here wanting to make some kind of an offer. This can be a decision between the two of you. There's obviously, this for me is also a spinner because this is a no contact situation. And it's somebody who has regret, but is having a hard time with their feelings. But maybe it's also because there's other connections, other contracts. We saw that in the Hierophant. But you're both here. And look at this lotus. This is healing. And everybody's connected. Divine connection. We know that as well. And yeah, guys, I mean, look at this. It's the Lover's card. It's the Six of Emotions. It's a ton of emotions. And I would love to say, look, so you guys are going to decide, maybe you're going to be together and you're going to have a reunion. You're going to live happily ever after. You're going to come with the truth here and they're going to upright this someday because it's minor arcana in the partnership placement and make a decision. We saw that they're blocked in it with the High Priestess, but we also saw, what was that coming down? Well, the Justice was there too already. Justice was already there. She's been residing over the court of this love court for the very beginning of the reading. And now she's like, yeah, I'm here to stay. So can it be? Yeah, but I'm not, you know, I would never make that promise. And, you know, if that resonates for you and that is to be, then that's to be. But there's also a strong energy of a connection that might not be able to be realized in that way. With that said, look what the energy is here now. It's the Nine of Pentacles. This is Virgo and Mercury energy. Mercury, the planet of the mind, the planet of communication. Virgo, lots of details. The Queen of Pentacles can start a lot like the Empress. You know, she's a very resourceful queen and she can just really begin things. She has everything, you know. It's like this kind of energy too of the home here, and somebody who's, it's the kind of person that you see like those friends, you know, and they're walking around and they're just getting all these things done. They're like coming over to you to bring you your coffee as you wait. And then in the process, they're like, you know, stopping the baby from falling off the table. And, you know, and that may not resonate with you. It's just an example, you know, and then pick something up along the way and picks up a call and handles something important, hangs up the phone, comes over, still brings you your coffee, like perfect cup. This is, you know, the Queen of Pentacles. Look, it's abundance. It can be reunion energy. It's, she's wearing them. Look, it's a decision also for that. And this is, you know, it's, what can I say? This is a really beautiful energy with the floral energy, and it can be reunion energy. And there's, look, she's here feeling good about it too. I mean, it's the queen, but it's also bringing in two, you know? So it's sort of like, is the Queen of Pentacles able to, and this was just knocking this over. It's the Magician in reverse. Interesting. So this was happening, and this is going to stay here, guys. I think this is how the reading is going today. Yeah. Okay. And then I'm going to show you what's here. Look. Okay. Yeah. This is how the reading wanted to be. This was really similar, different, but similar in some ways to how my Capricorn reading came down, a different deck today. And yeah, it's just sort of wanting to go through the deck in a different way. It's the High Priestess back, and the High Priestess is not blocked anymore. The High Priestess is making a decision. Cancer and Divine Feminine Energy, what? To share something? to something that's been hidden for a while. They finally trusting themselves. Is this also you possibly? Are you making a decision together? Interesting, because this is feeling like this was what was interrupted with the Ten of Emotions. Yeah, and I just feel like this person is really has a lot of regret here about how things went, decisions that were made and not made. And it could have been when that High Priestess is in reverse. It's a major arcana, and it's really just found a way to come back in the upright. Now it's the Magician in reverse. And I just want to show you the card. It's Gemini Virgo energy. It's planet of the mind, planet of communication, as above, so below. Everything needing to work out, you know, what you the connection here, the spiritual connection, the spiritual realm, in order for it to bring it to fruition, but also manifesting that and taking inspired action. It is soulmate energy wherever it is, guys, okay? Up, sideways, whatever, which can sometimes be, yeah, for me, not realized in the making and decision, that sort of thing. It is in reverse, and I just want to show you the actual card. And all the elements are here, earth, water, air, and fire. And that's everything. It's the friendship, it's the love, it's the clarity, it's the commitment, it's the passionate energy, it's everything lining up. The four areas of support and stability, mental, emotional, physical, and spiritual. The new beginning here with the one, the opportunity for that new beginning, okay? The potential and the connection. And it's just interesting because it's coming down in reverse here. And this is that somebody, and this is why I feel like this happened. Yeah. Okay, so that's what it is. It's somebody stuck here about this commitment, stuck in this energy. This can be upturned at any time, and it cannot be that these things come to realization. But this, for me, is a stuck energy of what was, what could be, what happened in this connection. Because what we see here, a catty corner to the Ten of Emotions, because the Magician card is somebody who was wasting their resources. So the Magician was wasting the resources from the Queen of Materials, you know. The Queen of Materials is here like, yeah, I have everything here. We have everything. And the Magician in reverse is somebody who was, yeah, wasting it, you know. Emotional energy, not balancing it out, just taking somebody for granted. The commitment, you know, the practicalities, maybe just not being willing to, because it's slow moving, but possibly making somebody not feel like they're committed, that they're safe, running from the connection, having other connections. It's bringing in the clarity, somebody who was maybe not being clear. So the Queen of Materials can come here and say, well, here's a clear glass of water. You know, it's emotional energy. It's the divine. And the Magician in reverse is like, yeah, I want a different glass, you know, and is like dumping it out or just knocks it over and breaks the glass. The water goes everywhere. It's that feeling because the resources were, you had something here, okay? Or the potential for something. And this person, whether they wasted it away by lying, by hiding how they feel about you, or maybe even having other connections or just being blocked. And I just feel this apologetic energy that they're sorry. This is a really strong connection with this person. And it could be, yeah, you know, somehow that they get something through to you, but it could be that it's never realized in a message or in a voicemail or whatever, which I feel can be that this is the message too. But if they're upwriting this day-to-day stuff and they can stay in it, it might be that they just come out of nowhere and have something to say because this is the truth coming. But look what's here. It's also the Justice, which we saw in reverse, now is landed in their energy in the upright, and it's the Magician in reverse. And this is a little bit of scattered energy again. It's wasting those resources and the potential that was there, which is, we see that there's a lot of potential here in that one, and they were wasting that chance to say what they needed to say. So it's past energy too, and sharing when they could, or being honest about something here, not knocking the glass over, whatever it is, because it's in reverse here. And this is the first, you know, this is, well, it's after the Fool. It's like a really mature, realized version of the Fool, by the way. It's the second it's the second, because the Fool, of course, is the zero. And but there's still a lot of that Fool energy. It's cycling, you know. I feel that. Uranus energy of the Fool card, especially because this is in reverse. So it's not quite a fully realized magician. There's still an imbalance. They're still kind of stuck in the Fool energy too, and we see that. You know, so justice can come here and reside and come and walk through here and say, I'm here to restore balance. I'm here to bring the truth. But the magician holds up their wand and says, yeah, no, I'm going to just flick that wand and close the opening here because I'm not ready. It's scattered energy. It's wasting what could have been or what can be possibly. It's going to just be different for everybody. Okay, you guys, so this person I do feel is... yeah, stuck, apologetic. There's love here. We know it. A lot of sentimental energy. It can be that a voicemail or a message makes its way through to you. And for some of you, it really can be. You know, this is everything. Spirit has a plan, divine timing. I've said that before. Divine timing's for everyone. You know, it sounds so goofy, but I mean, it is. So it can be that this is unblocked now and this person decides to come here and say this to you. And maybe that you guys make a decision to kind of plan some kind of reunion. Maybe you see each other, you know? That can be the case for some of you. I'm not going to make empty promises because there's different energies coming through depending on free will and choices. Everyone has free will. Free will and choices connect with fate and destiny, controlling what you can, letting go of what you can't, you know? And so the moves that people make are going to affect this outcome, whether or not things are going to come together in person, online, or this is simply the message here today. Okay, you guys, I want to bring in some oracle cards. And then we're going to bring in some messages from their higher self, some love messages, and close your reading today. Thank you, spirit guides, angels, and ancestors. Please show us the card of cards as it may be. Aho. That's for sure yours. Yeah, super moon, really strong attraction to each other. This is a master number 44. So angels, a soul connection, but you know, soul connections, I want to remind you that it doesn't always mean life partners. You know, it can be that there's always going to be a lesson in a soulmate connection in particular, and a twin flame journey is a whole nother thing. I have lots of twin flame readings down there if you want to check those out, if you're new to my readings, where the whole reading is about your twin flame journey. So that is a little bit of a different energy, you know, that particular contract, but it is here. There's a super strong attraction to each other. You can't miss this moon. They know it, but it's here. Look with the clouds, the indecision. Angels are here. There is a connection. Somebody here is kind of pondering, pensive, you know? And that's very much what I feel in this energy too. Okay, there's two that came down. Yeah, look, there's the pensive self-reflection and trust. Trusting in the timing is what's coming through for me. Oh my gosh, wait, let me look and see. Yeah, look, there are two people embraced here. There's a nest above it. There's a duck protecting it. This is the divine protecting this connection. Trusting. Oh my gosh. Why is that little baby duck out there? The moon isn't quite full. Here it's full. Egg moon. Okay. So yeah, the egg moon, it's like incubating, you know, sitting here keeping this huge egg warm. My gosh, you guys, that's like, yeah, I mean, this is divine timing for me. It's sitting on here, protecting it. It's underneath the nest. It was too big to fit in the nest. This little duck is like, hello, what about me? Where am I going to go here? This is coming to a five. That is, yeah, it's about change. It's also your spirit guides, angels, and ancestors sending you a love nudge. And it's also the truth being revealed eventually, this birthing here, this rebirth, look, and it's quite literally this connection of two people, two souls, two spirits and souls here in the human existence and protected here, I feel, by the divine timing. It will eventually trust the process. Spirit has a plan. And this is really just, wow, guys. that the truth will be revealed. Hi guys, sorry about that camera. This is, I was saying it's interesting because it's clearly the divine. There's, you know, but it's also, it's new beginnings. It's also like the moon card for me in many ways, as I talked about, somebody was reflecting and then we saw this mirroring, triggering, twin flame energy. Yeah. Also thinking about this connection big time. Look at this. And looking at themselves as well and what part they played, what part you both have in this connection. As the healing is going on here, is this what's going to happen in this new beginning? Are they going to come out, these lovers? Are they going to come out and go separate ways? Are they going to be joined? Right now, it's time will tell. It's protected by the divine here. It's incubating. It's incubating under the full moon too. That's kind of interesting, which is, you know, showing everything here and trusting your intuition and trusting yourself. I mean, that really is the message here with the egg moon, of trusting that this is in the process still. It's not time. It's not full yet. You know, the sun needs to be shining on it, which is the conscious, the knowing, the crown chakra, God, God is the universe. And it shines on the moon and it makes it full and reveals everything. Yeah, I just wanted to show you that. Look at how high these emotions are, how deep here. And it's four. Excuse me, guys. I had to edit out a cough, so I don't know if that made a little funky edit. But anyway, it's the four here, four areas of support. It's really much emotional, physical, and spiritual. There's the moon. It's almost full, but it's not quite full right here in the divine. Sort of like you could go here or you could go in here. It's, are we coming? Are we going? It's an illusion. It's also self-reflection, which we know, just how, what part did I play? How do I feel? Oh my gosh, you guys. Yeah. And this person is, I feel like, not completely in here yet. There's something still kind of disconnected for me in their life. Maybe it's in their life. I'm getting some kind of emperor vibes in that, that maybe there's something there, have quite a busy life, or they're in charge of other people or things, you know. It can also be you, and it's not necessarily divine masculine energy, because the emperor holds an ankh, which brings in divine feminine energy too. And yeah, so that could also be you. I don't know, I'm just feeling that. Guys, I'm going to bring in some love messages from their higher self. We're going to actually begin with some song messages today. Can be your song comes down, it can be not. You could hate the song or never have heard of it, okay? It's coming through as a message for you through song from your person. Maybe you're sending it. Excuse me, my sweater is really bothering me. I just need to fix it here. And it's not about loving or even liking the song or knowing it. It can be the sentiment behind the song, and it can be messages coming through, you know, name, location, that sort of thing that I don't even know. And if you feel you're sending it, you're sending it. Please show us. Oh, I just saw a love message in there. You, soft and only you, lost and lonely you, strange as angels dancing in the deepest oceans, twisting in the water, you're just like a dream, just like heaven, the cure. Yeah, this is, gosh, you guys, a lot of emotional energy here. Somebody really wants to say that to you, come to you and tell you, and look what I realized was here. It's the Muse of Materials. I didn't even talk about it. It's the King of Pentacles. It's Virgo, ruled by Mercury, and it's all the details. And it's not in upright and it's not in reverse. It's in motion. It's indecisive. Before we continue on, this just fell off, so we will look at it. It's trusting in the process and divine timing. This person is walking toward it. Look, there's more roses, I feel. It's funny because I was looking at this the other day and I thought they were hot air balloons. Then I thought they were apples. Now I'm seeing them as roses. Interesting, but they're blocking the sun. That brings in both sides now too, by the way. Now, oh, look what just came with it. Oh my gosh. Look, and I didn't even get your overall energy. I still need to get that. Wow, you guys. Now they only block the sun. That's both sides now, Joni Mitchell. Now they only block the sun. Those are the roses, the growth, the red, the offer that they couldn't, the mistakes, the regret. That's the lovers in reverse that I kept seeing, because they're blocking the sun here. So this person Yeah, and it's like I said, it's not upright and it's not reverse for me, but look at your energy exchange. You're just touching here. It's both adorned with roses, what you think about. It's the Muse of Materials, and again, that's bringing in Mercury for us, but I feel like there's a lot of details and that's why it's like this. Other things going on here. So this is the Joni on both sides now. I can't fit that on here, so I'm just gonna leave it for you. It brought in a feather with it. This was yours too, so it brought this in as well. Okay. Gosh, you guys, your reading's beautiful. Times were tough. We made it through. We tasted the rough, so let's save the spoon. All the time I was hurting, got to believe that I was hurting too. I was born to love you. Ray LaMontagne. This got left behind. Sometimes it amazes me how strong the power of love can be. Sometimes you just take my breath away. You take my breath away, Eva Cassidy. You guys, because that's the breathlessness that I was feeling. Before we continue on, I've got to get it. Better late than never. I've just been really forgetting lately, but it doesn't matter. It will either validate or a reading or bring in new insight. Please show us the overall energy for our beautiful soul watching today. Oh, wow. Look, kind of was like this and then it turned around here. It's the Star card. Aquarius energy. This is renewal and hope. Wanting things, I feel like, to restart, having hope. It's kind of this miracle energy and it's a spinner for me because it came like this and then it kind of did this in my hand and I was going to turn it and then I was like, oh no, Spirit said, no, it's not quite the upright. It's here. You know, that eighth star, by the way, this is a 17, it comes to an 8. That eighth star is connected to the strength card, to Leo energy, of loving yourself also. And that's also connecting to the sun, your God, your goddess, the universe, the source. And that's what we talked about, the source that hasn't fully realized this full moon. It's trusting in this timing. Can we have an overall energy for our person here, someone? For their person. Look, we're seeing the Ace of Wands. Yeah, that is that Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy of something maybe just being kind of out of the blue. Okay, this is, I don't know, it went flying and it came like this. Look, it's the Nine of Pentacles that we saw. It's coming here in reverse, but it was sort of like this. But yeah, this is the thing. For some of you, there might be other people in the connection that you're feeling a little bit jealous of, and it could be vice versa. Somebody here, whether it's you or both of you, might be overworking. The main thing here, it's the Nine of Pentacles coming back, which I kind of felt in reverse, is, yeah, I mean, it's coming in reverse here. So it's saying that things aren't, it's slow moving, and it's still slow moving, this connection. It's kind of like setbacks, you know? And this, let me just get this, hold on, there we go. This fortress here is the journey of love here. So this connection, and it's in reverse. This is your person's energy. It's missing that pentacle here. It's missing this King of Pentacle energy. They're kind of just standing here, not moving in yet. Knowing what they need to say to you, and I feel like knowing what they want. And look, I mean, you guys, this came in, this little, it's a little bit tattered feather. So you guys, this for those of you on a twin flame journey or past life connection, I feel like it's many cycles here. This feather's been through a lot. I don't even know where it came from. It just wanted to be in your reading. Okay, please show us the songs. What do you want to say through song? I couldn't help but ask for you to say it all again. I tried to write it down, but I could never find a pen. I'd give anything to hear you say it one more time, that the universe was made just to be seen by my eyes, sleeping at last Saturn, that's this, the attraction, sitting here possibly a strong, actually, energy of dreamy energy with that ton of emotions at night, dreams, just thinking about you, thinking about how you could see each other again, having trouble writing, having trouble saying what they want to say. Yeah, wanting to hear from you, wanting to talk to you, but look, it's literally Saturn here. It's the energy, it's slowing it down. Look at the feather here. My gosh, you guys, you're reading. Yours was the first face that I saw. I think I was blind before I met you. First day of my life, bright eyes. These are pushing off, so is that. Okay, this is the last three. That just was really clear to me. that that's how it wanted to come down. Let's look at the middle. That's what I do. And darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23, thinking out loud at Sharon. That's very soul connection energy, you know, twin flame, soulmate energy. Yeah, it's just imagining the longevity here. I love that trust card that came down for you. I cannot be from you. Whoa, what was that? I cannot hide from you. It almost said lie. Look, but that's B. And then I got this weird vocal thing. I cannot hide, and I'm losing the will to try. Can't hide it. Breathless chords, that's why. It's more of the breathless energy, which I've been feeling since the beginning of the reading. That wand energy, I was feeling like I was ahead of myself. It was fast. So it can be that there's kind of that feeling of just kind of coming out of nowhere, somebody being impulsive. And being apart ain't easy on this love affair. Two strangers learn to fall in love again. Faithful. It's like a love letter to you too. Journey, about this journey you're on. You guys, what a beautiful reading. I'm going to bring in some little itty bitty messages from their higher self today and some love notes. Then we're going to close your reading. I could keep going, but I feel like I need to close now. I'm feeling like the energy is kind of pulling away. Please never give up on us. I don't feel good enough for you. That's in the self-reflection in the lover's card. We belong together. Please forgive me. Yeah, that's a strong energy. It actually wants to be here as I said that. It was like, no, it goes over there. It's three the most I'll take, and then there's one here and one here, and they're separate. What's going on? I care too much what people think. So this is Hierophant energy too. Cultural, religious differences, maybe someone in their ear, in their life, differences, you know, change. It's not kind of like, it's not just even about somebody being blocked spiritually, mentally, emotionally. That comes through, but I feel like it's physically. I made so many mistakes. I received your telepathic messages. These two. So many songs remind me of you. Yeah, I felt a really strong musical connection here. You are the love of my life. Playlists, telepathically, whoa, sending each other songs. Because that was really, I received your telepathic messages. Just kind of hearing stuff and thinking of your person or going, why is this song coming on? I am afraid to contact you. That's really strong energy too, of kind of writing messages that they don't send. I was scared. It's the running energy. This is the last one, guys. I am so sorry I hurt you. Don't like to cover up the lover's card, but you know, by the end of the reading, there's a lot of things covered up. It's just kind of how it is. What do you want to say to your person? Embracing you, sending you this, thinking of you, imagining it. It's the Ten of Cups, it's the attraction, it's kind of everywhere. It's the lover's card, it's the Six of Cups. I miss you. That's here for sure. Look at that. Longingly. Here, just want to show you that Scorpio energy. You know, Scorpio lives along here, but you know what else lives here in that water is fish, Pisces, Cancer, crabs are around. Again, there's three here in the divine. Look, this is also a divine trinity for some of you. It's you, your person, and the divine. Divine timing. Super emotional. Putting that I miss you there. And I just actually want your lover's card out for you. These don't need to be there. They can be, that, is that coming? No, that's not coming, okay. The embrace. I wish we could be together. That's here too. I write letters that I never send. Yeah, that came through many times. Couldn't find a pen. I tried to write it down. And when that came through, that they are having a hard time. They might be unsending them. Maybe even some came in and got unsent, you know what I mean? Suddenly it's, you can see that sometimes on social media come back. Whoa. They're feeling this energetic pull of you moving away. You could also be sending this to this person, to your someone. Why is it doing that? Come on now. Would you please clear up for me? Come back. Beautiful souls, what's your reading today? I really appreciate you being here. Thank you so much for giving me your time. If you enjoyed today's reading, I would really appreciate it if you liked the reading and subscribe to the channel. It helps so much more than you know, so that I can keep growing and yeah, that more people can see the readings so I can bring you more readings. And make sure you have your notification bell on so you know when your readings are coming. Perhaps you want to watch zodiac signs, messages from your spirit guides. And I'm trying to get my internet sorted. I'm going to be going live a lot as soon as I work on that. I just haven't had the time to troubleshoot it the way that I want to. I think it's the internet. In any case, I'm going to be doing a lot of collective readings, readings like this for you, how they feel about you, messages from your person. And yeah, zodiac sign lives. So you might want to know when things are happening, whether a reading is for you or not, if you're waiting it out or going down in the playlist, the notification bell will help you, yeah, just kind of keep up with readings that are coming in. Okay, you guys, thank you very much for being here. I am ready for, I feel like a nap. Take really good care of yourselves. Thanks again. Have a beautiful day. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. And I'll see you at another reading. Bye.